4.4 होम स्वीट होम। मिड प्लेजर्स एंड पैलेसेस, दो वी मे रोम, बी इट एवर सो हम्बल, देयर्स नो प्लेस लाइक होम। ए चार्म फ्रॉम द स्काई सीम्स टू हैलो अस देयर, विच सीक थ्रू द वर्ल्ड इज नेवर मेट विथ एल्सवेयर। होम होम स्वीट स्वीट होम, देयर्स नो प्लेस लाइक होम, ओ देयर्स नो प्लेस लाइक होम। एन एक्साइल फ्रॉम होम स्प्लेंडर डेजल्स इन वेन, ओ गिव मी माय लोली थैच्ड कॉटेज अगेन। द बर्ड्स सिंगिंग गेली दैट कम एट माय कॉल, Give me them and the peace of mind dearer than all. Home, home, sweet, sweet home. There's no place like home. Oh, there is no place like home. I gaze on the moon as I tread the drear wild. I feel that my mother now thinks of her child. As she looks on that moon from our own cottage door, through the woodbine whose fragrance shall cheer me no more. Home, home, sweet, sweet home, there's no place like home. Oh, there's no place like home. How sweet 'tis to sit 'neath a fond father's smile, and the cares of a mother to soothe and beguile. Let others delight mid new pleasures to roam, but give me, oh, give me the pleasures of home. Home, home, sweet, sweet home, there's no place like home. Oh, there's no place like home. To thee I'll return, over burdened with care, the heart's dearest solace will smile on me there. No more from that cottage again will I roam, but it ever so humble, there's no place like home. Home, home, sweet, sweet home, there's no place like home. Oh, there's no place like home. The poet is very fond of his home and remembers it with love when he is away. He says that though we may roam around palaces and pleasure-filled places, there is no place like home, however simple it may be. Something magical from the sky seems to have made it holy. We cannot find this anywhere else in the world. However much we may search for it, there's no place like home, sweet home. The magnificence of other places does not impress the poet when he forced to be away from home. He longs for his simple thatched cottage where the birds sing gaily and respond to his call. The poet longs for these birds, but most of all he wants the peace of mind that he has when he is at home. The poet looks at the moon as he walks uninterestedly in some wild places. He feels that his mother is now thinking of him as she looks at the same moon from the door of their cottage. He remembers the woodbine, the plant whose sweet, pleasant smell can make him happy no more. He again longs for his home. He remembers his father and says that it is so sweet to sit under his fond smile with his mother's loving touch comforting and distracting him. He says, let the others roam around in new places with delight. He wants the pleasures of his home. The poet finally tells his home that he will return to it full of worries and troubles. He will be fully comforted there and he will never go away from his cottage again. However, simple and inexpensive it may be, there's no place like home, he repeats. Answer the following questions. How does the poet glorify his home in the first stanza? The poet says that though we may roam around palaces and pleasure-filled places, there is no place like home. However simple it may be, something magical from the sky seems to have made it holy. We cannot find this anywhere else in the world, however much we may search for it. How does the poet describe his home in the second stanza? The poet says that his home is a simple thatched cottage where the birds sing gaily and respond to his call. He gets the longed for peace of mind when he is home. What makes the poet remember his mother? The sight of the moon in the sky makes the poet remember his mother. What does the poet miss? The poet misses the gaily singing birds, the fragrant woodbine, his father's fond smile, and his mother's loving caress. And of course, he misses his humble thatched cottage. What does the poet hope for? The poet hopes to return to the home and never leave it again.